Microsoft Power Automate Cloud is going to be the solution that is going to allow you to save countless hours of time by integrating different web applications and APIs together. This might sound complicated, but if we go to Microsoft Power Automate and we go inside of the templates, we can see hundreds of different templates that have been already created for simple processes that if we wanted to code ourselves using code would be very complicated and we would have to use different APIs and so forth. With Microsoft Power Automate Desktop, it's just a click process to set up these applications and these interactions that can allow us to save time and also create processes that we have never thought about creating previously. There are different ways that we can create a process or an automated cloud flow in Microsoft Power Automate Cloud. The first is by using the Copilot. The Copilot is a feature that is going to allow the generation of different functionalities based on the text that you input. So in this example, we are going to create a process for every day post a message for a chat or a channel in Teams. So we have the actions that would be required to create this process. However, we are not going to be using Microsoft Power Automate Copilot to create a process. We're going to create a process from scratch. Why? Because it is important to understand how we can create these processes, but also how these processes are triggered initially. What I mean by this, any automation can be triggered automatically or with some sort of event or trigger. And Power Automate Cloud allows us to create different events and triggers to trigger and start our automation. So for example, we can create an automation that would be a scheduled cloud flow. That means an automation that is going to run every minute on this date, starting on this date and at this time. We could configure this to our liking in order to have our automation run on specific intervals of time. In addition to this, we can also create instant cloud flows and automated cloud flows. Automated cloud flows are going to be triggered by different events that happen automatically. So for example, if we wanted to create an event on our Gmail that is listening for different email addresses, we would just type in for the connector or application that we want to interact, see if we have a connector and select that connector. So this, in this example, our trigger or our starting process would be when a new email arrives, we would then trigger the remaining of our actions. So let's create actually an instant cloud flow. An instant cloud flow is going to be a manually triggered flow. That means that once we click a button, either on Power Automate Cloud or on a web application or make an API call or some sort of event happens, our process is going to start. So let's call this send email. And we're going to create a process that is going to be manually triggered with a button from Power Automate Cloud. And it is going to send emails by reading a Google Sheets Drive document. So it's going to read this document that I have created right here with different emails. And it is going to send an email to each one using a custom subject and a custom body. Now imagine if you wanted to contact your users and you wanted to write a custom message for each one of them, you could use GPT to create a custom body and a custom message and use Power Automate to automate the entire process of sending the emails. So let's see how we would go about doing this. This is a blank canvas that has been created for us that is going to allow us to add all of different actions and configurations. If we click in this first action that has been created, we have a pop-up that appears on the left side with different configuration parameters that we can add to this action. Each action that we are going to add is going to have different configuration parameters, allowing us to fine-tune each action. So let's add a new action. The first action is going to search on Google Sheets. So let's search for Sheets inside of the actions and see what actions we have available. Get rows, insert row, and get sheets. In our example, we have to get all of the rows from this sheet right here. So let's add this get rows right here. Once we have added the action, I have already set up a connection, but you can set up different connections that are going to connect to different Google Drive documents that you have available for you. In the settings, code view, testing, and about, you have different configurations that are going to allow you to further fine-tune each one of the actions. In this example, and for most of the actions that you're going to create, you're just going to be using the different parameters to configure the action. So in this example, we're going to pick the file that we want to work on. So we're going to go to my Google Drive and select this email example file that I'm going to be using. We're also going to pick the worksheet from this file. And we also have additional information or additional configuration that can limit and fine-tune the search or the elements that we retrieve. So what is going to be next? The next is to send an email to each one of those lines that are inside of this sheet right here. So to do that, I would just search for Gmail again, and I would see what kind of actions are available. So we have a reply to email, a send email, and get email details. So let's add the send email. And again, we see that we have different parameter configuration that we can add. So in this tool, let's add the address. But once we click on this, something happens. These two buttons appear. So this button is going to give us the ability to interact with dynamic data. Now, what is dynamic data? Dynamic data is the data that is generated, for example, by all of the different actions that we have. This action that we added, get rows, has dynamic data that connects to this sheet and allows us to interact with this sheet. What do I mean by that? So if we click here in this action, send email, click on our tool address, click on the arrow, and we see that we have get rows, which is our previous actions, and we have email, sub, and body, which are the fields of our email. So it has identified those as the different columns and is giving us the ability to interact with that data without us writing even a single line of code. So let's add the email in this example. And something else great has happened. Now we see that this email action that we have added right here has been encapsulated inside of a for each. What is a for each? A for each is just a cycle that is going to repeat this action for each line that we have here. Power Automate Desktop was smart enough to identify that this action right here needs to be repeated for as many lines that we have right here. So it created this action automatically for us. In addition to this, if we go to the parameters, we have the ability to configure the remaining parameters, such as, for example, CC of the email, the subject, and let's add the subject, the body, and let's add the body. And our email has been configured so that it is going to take all of the information from this Excel sheet and create and send emails based on our process right here. So let's save this process, and once we save our process is going to be available for testing and for later execution. Once our process is saved, we're ready to test our first process. And just in a few actions, such as get rows and send email, we have created a very cool automation that could help us automate the sending of emails. Let's test our process and see what happens. We are signing into the different connectors that we have to Google Sheets and Gmail. So these are pre-built connectors that have and that are available in Power Automate. Let's run our flow and see what happens. So once our flow is running, we see that we have already executed this step, the first time, this step, 1 out of 3. We are running step 1 out of 2 and 3, and all of the steps have been executed. If we go back to the send email to the process flow run page that we can also access from my flows right here. And if we go inside of send email, we can see the details of our flow. This is very important information because it's going to allow us to fine tune our process and also identify issues with each single run. So if we in the bottom of the page, we're going to see every single run that our process has executed. So if we click inside, we're going to see details and see any potential issues or breaks inside of our process. Now if we go back on the right side in the top, we're going to see all of the different connections that we're using, and we can use multiple connections, a different connection for Gmail, a different connection for Google Sheets, and so on. In addition to that, we also have the ability to improve our process by exporting this information inside of the process mining tool and visualizing each single run and each single path that our process is taking inside of process mining, the dedicated application for investigating processes inside of Power Automate Desktop. I have created a custom and dedicated video to that. The link will be in the description down below. Now that we have created our first process, it is going to be available from our processes. From our processes, we can also see the different desktop flows that we have created, processes that are shared with me within my organization, and also any quick template that we could use to create a process right out of the box. In addition to that, Power Automate Cloud, you have access to different tools that are going to be available in this submenu. If you don't see them, click on the More action, and you're going to have access to the AI Hub, which is a great functionality. I have created different videos on how to use the AI Hub, so check them out also down in the description below. I strongly recommend that you log into Power Automate and start creating your processes. Having these skills is essential to upskilling yourself and having the competences that are going to be required in this coming days, months/years. Thank you so much for watching the RPA Champion, and I will see you in the next video.